Welcome back to AM Northwest. You know, these days it seems kindness, caring, and generosity are in short supply. Here to share how we can cultivate more of it, starting with ourselves, we welcome the author of The Kindness Quotient, Rhonda Sciortino. Good to have you with us again.
I'm so happy to be here.
Okay,
thank you.
You believe kindness is very important, which seems to make sense. What is the idea behind the title, The Kindness Quotient?
Well, the idea is that we are aware of random acts of kindness. We
right.
talk about being kind to people, hold open the door, you know, be nice to people, pay a compliment here or there. And that is super easy
yeah.
when we're not in relationship with people.
Right.
So you can be kind to somebody that you have a 10-second transaction with. But going home and being kind to the person who's irritable or grouchy or ill and just not able.
Oh, it's tough.
Right?
Yeah.
And so I wanted to name this, The Kindness Quotient, with the subtitle, How to Be Kind to Jerks, Jokers, and Jackasses. But the publisher shut that down.
Darn
so,
it.
I know, right? But, you know, being kind to people who cannot or will not reciprocate is
right.
pretty tough.
That's tough. So you talk about the secret meaning of kindness.
Yes. So the secret meaning of kindness is giving dignity.
Oh.
Right? So if you really determine that regardless of how the other person is going to treat you, you're going to be kind. You're
oh.
going to look them in the eyes and make eye contact.
That would be hard.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
You're
going to
really listen to what they say, even when what they say is abrasive or
right.
rude or mean-spirited. But you're really going to listen instead of what most of us do because we're always pressed for time. We're thinking about what we're going to say and how we're going to respond. Or we interrupt and commandeer the conversation. But when we really listen, when we give eye contact, we're giving dignity and we're really saying, you're worthy. You're worth my time. You're valuable. And my relationship with you is more important than being right.
But if someone is a jerk or someone is being mean to somebody else, aren't you enabling them to continue to be mean if you've shown them kindness as opposed to just dismissing them?
No, that's a great question. It's not to say that we don't bring correction.
Okay.
But it goes back to the old saying of you praise in public and you correct in private.
Oh.
Right? So if you have something to say to someone and you need to bring correction, then you choose the right time.
Okay.
And you make sure that the relationship is intact. Because when people know that we care about them, they're far more willing to listen to what we have
oh,
to
true.
Say.
That's
right?
true. What is the hidden power of kindness, you think?
Oh, the hidden power of kindness is that it chips away at social isolation. So we know that societal ills, domestic violence, child abuse, the commercial sexual exploitation of children,
yeah.
homelessness, depression, it all stems back to social isolation. And so when we're kind to someone, when we say, hey, sit down and join me for lunch.
Right.
Hey, come over for dinner. Hey, I'm going to the movies. You want to go? Just to include people, we're chipping away at that social isolation that can just drive people further and further and further into depression. And so it's powerful. People think that kindness is such a weak, meek, inconsequential thing.
Right.
And it's really
not. It's
not.
You talk about a kindness ambassador.
Yes. Okay, so when we deliberately decide that we're going to be kind regardless of how the other person treats us, this
mm-hmm.
could just be the meanest, grouchiest person. To me, I hear the most broken or most wounded or somebody who's suffering from an illness. Think of an Alzheimer's patient who maybe doesn't even have the capacity
right.
to reciprocate kindness.
Right.
When we decide that we're going to be kind to those people in our lives, regardless of how they treat us, that we're just going to ignore offense, what happens is we get happier. There are actually two studies that show that when we're kind, we're happier. When we're happier, it increases our capacity to be kind. So what happens is when you start to do that, it becomes a cycle.
Okay.
And then it becomes a lifestyle. And so that's what I mean when I say being a kindness ambassador. It's people who have determined that they're going to make kindness a lifestyle
right.
no matter what.
No matter what. You also have 9 principles of kindness ambassadors.
Yes. Okay. So the first principle in my mind, I mean, they're all important, but the first principle is self-care. Because if we're going to be kind to people who are mean and rude.
You have to be kind to yourself. Yeah,
right?
That
we
makes
have
sense.
To be kind
right.
to ourselves. We have to carve out time to You know, if it's take a hot bath, take a walk, read a book, whatever it is that we need to do for ourselves, because we have to know that we cannot count on other people to keep us happy or fix us or whatever. Another one really important is not take offense. You know, we have a tendency, I think, in our culture to get offended over everything.
Yeah.
If you believe this way and I believe that way, or you vote this way and I vote that way, oh my goodness, now we've divvied ourselves up into little groups, and I'm going to be offended by what you say, and that's going to, you know, influence and affect and probably diminish our relationship, right? So when we decide right off the bat, I'm not going to take offense. You get to be you. You can have your opinions, and I'm not going to try to persuade you. I get to be me.
Right.
Right? And so I will listen to you as to why you believe what you believe, and I might learn something, and I might be a better person for it, and vice versa.
Or you might learn you don't want to hang out with that person. How about that?
How about that?
Okay,
I mean, maybe.
There's that, too.
There's that.
The book, again, is called The Kindness Quotient. Thank you so much, Rhonda.
Thank
I appreciate
you.
It. This was very interesting.
All right, come